And now it's time for the Cottage Angler, brought to you by Interstate Battery.
You'll see just off of this dock, there's that isolated weed bed in here.
Yeah.
And rocks too.
There's weed right here. You see the little strands.
Yep.
That might be a little nicer. Oh, I think it is too. Unless that's just, oh yeah. Ooh. Might be nicer fish right here. Well, here we are, folks, fishing with my good buddy, longtime friend, Richard Colangelo. I got a feeling we got a big fish on here on a little cottage lake, and they say that there's some big bass in here. And here we are. We got something pulling the boat around here. Let's hopefully he stays hooked. Play that drag out. You see that? Sometimes I do come out early in the morning, folks. Oh, yeah, this is pretty big, I think, Richard. I'm going to keep letting him
bite. It looks pretty decent.
Stay hooked, big boy. You want to go with the trolling motor? Keep following him. Oh, yeah, he's big. I can't believe it. I think this is the pike or trout. You got pike in here? Watch this.
We have.
Watch this.
We have trout in here.
Look at this. It's a pike. Look at that. Pike. Wow.
In the many years I've been on this lake, this is the first pike I've seen.
No kidding, eh? I thought, you know what, this thing has got some size to it. How? Maybe from somebody's minnow buckets or?
Yep.
Look at that, eh? Early morning northern. He's a good size, too.
It certainly is.
This Cottage Lake has everything in it. I thought it was maybe a trout. Guys at home told me there's no pike in here. I want to get him there. Look at the size of him. Holy. Look where he got hooked too.
Right in the nose.
He wasn't coming out of there. Look at that.
Got him?
Yeah. Hey, that's one big fat pike on Little Cottage Lake. First thing in the morning, northern pike. Let's let him go. Okay, Mr. Northern, you fought good. He's around. Let's see. Once you get him, there he goes. There he goes. Well, we're after bass, and I thought that was probably a record bass until I saw him. Hey, Richard?
Yes.
Fishing with an old buddy, Richard Colangelo, on a little cottage lake, northeast Ontario, and we're gonna throw stick worms, spinner baits, rodents, all that little kind of stuff. Just we're gonna work around shorelines, and hopefully, get some nice big largemouth that pull that way. Basically, all we're fishing is cabbage patches, grass, a little bit of milfoil, and pads. Just going all the way along, follow the shorelines. Early August, the water's still not that warm, so we're gonna go along and just find all the aggressive fish that are on the feed, shoreline edges, maybe some rock piles and points and stuff like that. Small rods, spinning gear, a tough line. You saw it, that pike, man. It held up, even going through the weeds and stuff. Circle hook, little wacky hooks, and we're gonna move around.
But he put me right in the weed, eh? Yeah. I thought I had a monster.
Look at me eating a worm.
Yeah. Trying the 7-inch worm.
Now the sun's up a bit more. We started early. Took a bit of a break. And back at it.
Yep.
Bump the a little bit deeper weed.
Try something a little bigger than that.
Get one on a worm.
Yep.
A little cottage lake. Changed from the stick worm on the spinning gear, the stick worm on the bait cast gear. Look up there. A little largy.
Decent fish.
Hey, just a little guy. See the cottage lakes? Throw around those little stick worms, little baits. Get little bass, bigger pike, and hopefully big bass too. Little guy. Whoa, see him go? So we're just gonna play around. You know what? Go out here and have a blast. Get out. Soft plastics, shorelines, a little bit of cane and stuff, pencil weed. Just have fun. For an afternoon or early morning fish, you can't beat it. Time to catch here.
Small one, right on the edge.
Uh-oh.
Small one right on the edge. And right in the nose. Perfect little specimens. Get bigger.
By this tree, watch this. Yeah. Sitting by the tree. He wants to come and see me. I thought you were a bit bigger. That's all right. Little cottage lake, fish is big. Hey, you know how different to bite too? You can just tell right away. The line just slowly starts to go out. Slowly starts to go out. About the size of the other one. Well, little guy, go on, I know. Could be another one there because he bit right away.
Yep.
See, there's another guy here.
Go ahead, I'll.
Usually when they bite sometimes like that fast, it's a good indication it could be two fish there.
Yep.
Or even more. You know when the big guys are on the feed because they'll go right into the stuff.
Yep.
You know, a spot like that. When they're not there, those pounders find it.
Yep.
There, I told you about another one being there. See? Look at him fight. That's why the other guy came out so fast, because he was there. His little brother. You know what? Sometimes I fish so many tournaments and guest appearances and all kinds of stuff, you know, and fishing for the shows and stuff. It's high pressure. But sometimes coming up to a little cottage lake, a good buddy like Richard, catching bass like this, I can do this all day long. So can you. Find those little lakes. As long as I got a ramp and it's not private property, go in there, have a blast, catch some bass, and could be surprised too with pike, like we did. You get one fish, don't assume there's not more there. There's good cover, like here, it's got depth. It's dropping off the deep water. There's weed there, some boulders, some rock. Ideal situation. So sometimes on a new lake like this, let's say, go along and look for something that can congregate fish that has more cover than, let's say, the rest of the shoreline. Target those areas and really work them hard. You can get them. Richard, we never got the real big guy. We got a pike, smallmouth, largemouth. No giants, but you know what? It was just fun to be out. I guess we're going to wait to get back out again, fish for splake, eh?
Yeah, I guess so. Yes. All right. Yeah.
All right, folks.
It's a great time.